then just, you know, have fun with it.
Thank you, Aliaa. Yes, hello.
My question, my name is Roshan Raikar and I'm a global shaper too. My question is to Mr. Rao and Mittal both together. Mr. Rao, what I feel is the government is doing a lot of, there are a lot of policies and then facilities for the people, but the people are still not, you know, it's not reaching the people. And people feel that our voice is not reaching the government. And Mr. Mittal has the platform. So is there a possibility of a collaboration so that, you know, if I have a question, I quickly, you know, post it and then we quickly get a response. So the communication gap, if it is reduced, I think there will be a great impact which we can bring. So can there be a possibility?
What's your name, sir?
Roshan Raikar.
Roshan. Thank you, Roshan. It's a great question. How technology can be a great bridge between people and the government. In fact, India is the world's largest democracy, as you know. But there is absolute reality in what you said. There's a huge disconnect between the people and the government. In fact, a lot of times, because I have a lot of friends who are outside of politics, who are outside of government, so they give me some honest and brutal feedback. The general perception among people is that, you know, government money koi aur cheez hai. Matlab, this is something that I have nothing to do with. A lot of times, this is more so in the educated, you know, urban elite and urban middle class as well, where they believe that, you know, they have nothing to do with the government. I'm a firm believer, before I come to your question, I'm a firm believer in one theory. I've read this saying in JNU once sometime back in Delhi. It read, when politics decides your future, you decide what your future politics is. Point I'm trying to make is, aaj democracy mein har wo cheez aap istemal karte ho, uska politics se direct link hai, vaasta hai. आज सुबह जब उठते हो तो ब्रश जो यूज करते हो पेस्ट जो यूज करते हो जब सोते हो तो जो तकिया यूज करते हो हर चीज का पॉलिटिक्स से एक डायरेक्ट लिंक है अगर आप अलूफ रहोगे दूर रहोगे बोलोगे मुझे क्या लेना देना है और ये पॉलिटिशियन लोग सब चोर है ऐसे हैं वैसे हैं अगर आपको ऐसा लगता है देन मेक अ बेटर चॉइस दैट इज द वन थिंग आई वुड से एंड दैट डिस्कनेक्ट शुड गो अवे इवेंचुअली इफ वी रियली हैव टू ग्रो एंड यू नो स्ट्रेंथन आवरसेल्व्स एज अ कंट्री नाउ कमिंग टू द पॉइंट ऑफ हाउ टेक्नोलॉजी कैन बी अ ग्रेट ब्रिज बिटवीन गवर्नमेंट एंड पीपल I think we are constantly doing it. In fact, many politicians that I know, many ministers, many MLAs, many MPs are constantly on social media getting their feedback. We've also put up, you know, even if it is for the sake of optics, we all have put up dashboards on how we are working, in fact, as a government. Some governments are obviously more progressive, more dynamic when it comes to leveraging technology, some are not. But I'm sure there is a way where we can leverage tools like Hike, WhatsApp, in fact, sorry to say this, Kavin, but I use WhatsApp quite aggressively and extensively. In all my work, I have multiple responsibilities. And Karan said, how do you do it? I do it by way of technology. I have groups for each and every one of my flagship projects. I keep nudging my offices. I keep nudging my people, saying, guys, you have to get it right. Even as I sit here and as I speak to you, my phone, I'm sure, is loading all the updated pictures of what all has happened in different projects today. So technology is a great bridge. Technology is a great leveler. But I think that most important element of transparency, unless that comes in, people will not be satisfied. And that disillusionment and disconnect with people, between the people and the government, unless that goes away, there won't be a complete closure.
Kavin, you want to add to that?
I echo everything, you know, that's been said. And I think that technology is the one thing that can close the gaps of distance and the kinds of people. And I'm glad you asked the question because we're actually building something on Hike where we can channel the voice of the youth in a way it can be packaged to become actionable. If you have a billion people in this country, voices can get lost. How do you change that? And how do you make it, and this is where big data, for example, comes in. How do you take all these voices and package it in a way where it's useful to government, industries, and so on and so forth? So watch this space. Within 6 months, you'll see